Awesome. Thank you so much for having me. As already said, I'm Sebastian, one of the founders of luminovo. And yeah, cognitive computing, I'm going to get to that when my presentation is up. Let's wait for... Oh, no, it's already clicked. So yeah, as the name implies, I'm going to talk about something cognitive. But I think we are not that typical kind of startup. That's why I'm not going to give you this problems first kind of pitch, but I'm going to tell you our story. So our story starts with my co-founder, Timon, and I finishing up our master's in research at Stanford University in the field of AI. And we didn't do the standard route that all of our colleagues did and stayed in the valley, worked for the big tech giants, but we found our way back to Germany because we had the feeling that here we could accelerate the adoption of AI way more. We're not alone anymore. By now, we've assembled a team of 8 rock star engineers and business talents with, of course, the classic credentials you want to see on such a slide. And what have we done since the inception in December 2017? Is we have been solving business problems for corporations, mostly related to workflows on images and text. And this often involves consulting them because, let's face it, not everyone still knows what use cases an AI to tackle first. But what we did was not building some prototypes that the people can show around on a business dinner, but actually build applications that can serve in the production environment and create actual value for our clients. And this allowed us to be completely profitable and bootstrapped since 1.5 years now. And we have created actual impact for a lot of clients, being it helping a client like IDNOW completely launching a new product which disrupts their own product by full automation of a human workflow, being it by augmenting a tedious workflow at ProSieben in youth protection, or being it to change a massive redundancy in testing at a client like Infineon. And with all these clients, there was one thing we were converging towards, and that's a technology that we call our hybrid technology, which works best if, it combines a human and a machine, and these two together can solve tasks that no one of the individuals could do. And with this tech, we are very well equipped to tackle the cognitive process automation market, meaning not just process automation on a very repetitive and deterministic way, but in a more intelligent way. And this can work either in full automation when we talk about real-time cases, or the one we like best is co-processing, really taking the human and the machine jointly solving a task together. And ideally, we have human-centered workflows where we can apply this. And there are a lot of benefits if you really bring those two together. The human does something, basically infuses his or her brain into the machine, and the machine tries to understand as much as it can and take over the task it has understood. For us, this means you can deploy products faster to market than you could do if you want to build a full autonomous application. You can just take the system in working in the background, making your workflow smarter as you go, seamlessly integrating. And it actually continuously learns, because a lot of AIs do not learn. You have to build a lot of tooling around it to make them actually learn. And this is exactly what we did. And we see ourselves as this provider that helps you to mold the intelligence of your people and your data together in something that should be your IP and your IP only. So how does this fit into the whole 29 billion estimated automation market? If you have a team in-house that has a lot of labeling to do, you could go with a labeling provider, but they're not really focused on a workflow. You could just go with the classic cloud service providers offering standard APIs that are often not really serving the purpose that you want them to serve and are highly targeted to developers. The standard RPA systems or robots are mostly working on standard click flows, not on a complex task that's image or text related. And if you go for these document specific or text data type specific solutions, most of them work on templates and legacy systems, so not really equipped for the era of deep learning. And none of them really values the idea of model ownership and IP, which we highly believe in. So we are currently shifting from a more project-driven business to a co-development business. This project work we've done has allowed us to build out this tech completely without external funding, and now we're moving towards productization. And how we're doing this is working on 4 different co-developments with strong partners. That is one in the healthcare sector, in the legal space, and in the insurance space. In the vertical and in the horizontal, we are mostly talking about document processes and document mining. On all of them with a strong partner, where we have the clear goal of building this out and trying to scale the most successful one of these co-developments. And of course, all of them are using the technology that we've now built for 1.5 years. So what's the road ahead? Next 6 months are targeted to really mapping out these co-developments and trying to identify which ones of them we want to scale to which degree. Then fixing our growth strategy, and then actually raising growth capital for the first time, because then we really think it does make sense to accelerate our trajectory. So if you are someone who's interested in this journey, being it as a partner, as a client, or as a potential investor down the road, I'll be super happy to talk to you, either meet over there or just send me an email, and help us to drive progress by augmenting, not replacing, human intelligence. Thank you so much for your attention.